All right, so here I am in my boat. It's a little bit older. It's a little dirty right now. I usually keep it a little cleaner than this, but I'm not here to clean it today. I'm here to make sure that it stays dry. So the issue with this is that I have this old cover on it, and there's a couple leaks. It's not too bad, but the biggest issue is that up here, right where the cover bolts or clips on underneath the windshield, sometimes some water drips down here, and if you get an extended period of rain, it can really accumulate on the floor, and you can see that by a little bit of the mildew that's grown up, that's showed up there. So I have to clean that up still, but that showed to me that look, we have an issue here. And then I'd put my hand here, and it would be rather moist, and it would be damp even on extended periods of hot days. So there wasn't a lot of airflow coming through this cover, even when I would leave some of the flaps open like that to try to encourage some airflow so it could dry out. It wasn't enough. So what I've done is built a solar powered ventilation system. So I started off with this, this tin or aluminum hose that you can just get at any hardware store. You could use a dryer hose. You could use anything along those lines. I use this one because it's a little bit firm. It can kind of hold its position in there once I zip it all up. And I have that leading down all the way down to here, where I've bolted on a computer fan. This is just a basic, you know, PC fan. I think this is a 4-inch fan, and I have it bolted on here. Now, I had bought a smaller fan when we went to go do this, and it actually fell in the water. So we used this as the spare. It's working fine. Obviously, the size difference is a little off, as you can see, but it still works. And what we've done is we've just zip tied this onto the pipe or the tubing here. And it's held in place pretty strong, and I just let that kind of sit near the ground, where, again, here is really where the moisture is building up. So it pulls air through the tubing, and the air has to come through here. So it forces the air to come through this area and dry out. And now, for the first time in the season, it's bone dry on here. So I can finally clean this up and get this cleaned up nicely. So to power it, it's really simple. I've just taken, there's actually four cables that come on this thing, but two are for power, the other for control, and we don't need those, so I clipped those off. And these two power, I just have them coming all the way up here to a solar panel, and I bought this at Canadian Tire for 30 bucks. 10 watt solar panel, and I just have this sitting here on the dashboard, right in front of the window, and it's even on a cloudy day. Like, it is cloudy today, and it's only got a little bit of light hitting the solar array here, but doesn't matter because it's still enough to spin it. And that's all you need. You just need a small amount of power just to get some airflow. And this is all you need to do. And it keeps everything dry. And yeah, so it's pretty simple. You just wire the negative and positive to the wires on the back of the solar panel. You know, I just twisted them together with some electrical tape, and that's bam, all you need to do. And now my floor of my boat will finally stay dry, and I will clean up this gross, nasty stuff now, and I'm really happy that I can finally do that. Hope this helps. Hopes it gives you an idea. The whole project cost me, this was $6 or maybe $7. This was 11, and the solar panel was 30. So we've got a ventilation system for the boat that keeps moisture down and keeps your boat in good shape for under 50 bucks. I think it's worth it. Hope this helps. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below.